Yo everybody, what's up? Star here, bringing you commentary on Payload Barn Blitz. I almost wasn't going to do this commentary because I'm a little punk, and I have a cut on my lip, and it's hurting to talk right now. But I was almost going to use that as an excuse, like, you know what, maybe I'll do this commentary tomorrow. My lip kind of hurts, but then I thought, how lame does it sound that I can't make a video talking over a video game? I'm not manly enough because my lip has a little cut on it. And then I was like, wow, that makes me sound like a huge bitch. I should probably just do this commentary. So here we are playing Demo Man. Pretty much stock Demo Man. I got the grenade launcher, sticky launcher, and the frying pan, which comes into play later. Pretty funny, but we're gonna have to wait until see what happens there. They've got three sentries inside this building to start, so I'm just sort of, you know, peeking in here, trying to deal damage to whatever I can. We actually have a spy in there doing spy work at the moment, helping clear that out. So thank God, three sentries, seriously, in the same building. You think you could at least spread them out a little bit. Pro tip, if somebody else is building a level 3 sentry, don't build yours near it. They all become very easy to destroy with one Uber. So yeah, a couple of really random things to talk about Team Fortress 2 and this channel in general, myself playing it. We're playing Demo Man here. Usually I don't really like to post that much Demo Man gameplay because I find it to be one of the most basic classes, and in my personal opinion, boring classes to watch. Sometimes. A lot of times it just boils down to, hey, I'm spamming at these people. They're mostly around corners, and I'm just trying to get as much, like, area effect damage as I possibly can. Like, see, they're shooting around a corner. You don't even know who I'm shooting at. You gotta guess. Maybe that heavy's there. I don't know. It's just sort of waiting for people. Heavy, I find a little bit more interesting than Demo Man, usually, because at least you're, you know, you're trying to get in their face. You're in there all the time. You're in dead ass! And, I don't know. So, Demo Man, I don't usually post, but lately I've been posting a lot of Soldier, which a lot of people said, hey, Star! Enough with the Soldier already. Play something else. And I don't know, every time I jump into Team Fortress at the moment, I really just, that's all I feel like playing. Like, I look at the class list, I say, what should I play right now? Well, I'd like to play a class I can be aggressive with, go kill a lot of people, be very mobile, and I would like to actually win this match. Okay, Soldier. It boils down to that pretty much every single time I want to play, and I don't know, I've just been having the most fun with it lately. But I do run a YouTube channel, so it kind of has been a little bit of a rut and feels somewhat like a chore sometimes to jump on Team Fortress and feel like I have to play classes I don't feel like playing. That door's glitched, by the way. That's really messed up. Which I'm not complaining about. I'm not making excuses that, you know, oh, Team Fortress is so boring because I have to play the classes I don't feel like playing for you guys. I've set myself up for that. It's not a complaint. It's just saying that's the way things are. Just, I don't know, giving a heads up. I think I should honestly stop caring a little bit because then I would have a little bit more fun while I play sometimes. It's just, I don't know. There was a question I actually wanted to answer in one of the Answer Time videos, which was basically, how long does it take to make a video, not counting the time you spend towards gameplay? And for one, gameplay is kind of a big deal as far as time it takes to make some video, some of the time. Like the class tip video I made for Soldier for Tribes Ascend, I did not feel like playing Soldier at all. I really just, I was so bored of that class at the moment. I was just like, you know, I don't feel like playing a Spin Fuser, but I really want to make this video. And I spent a long time getting clips for a class I didn't feel like playing whatsoever. And that, it kind of ties into the overall time of making a video. So that's there. Rest of that in a second. Right here, I'm missing Soldier so much. I'm missing my Market Gardener. That I, and even as a Demo Man, I'm just like, you know what? I want to smash someone in the face! You don't even need the Market Gardener when random crits are on. Just destroy that guy. Not even worried about it. So, he's down. That's done. I miss my Market Gardener severely. But how long it takes to make a video and not counting the gameplay, there are some videos that I make that it's almost shameful to say that one of the videos I made, 10-minute long video, took me 2 hours to do the freaking commentary because I don't know, I just kept redoing stuff over and over and over again. I think that honestly made the video worse over time because it was like it was severely rehearsed because I kept like feeling like it wasn't good enough, so I kept redoing it. But whatever. Sometimes it's just, I don't know, I don't like putting things out that I feel are bad. But eventually it just came to the point where with that particular video I said, you know what? I have got to finish this sometime, so I should just call it right now. You know, 2 hours is enough to spend on 10 minutes worth of commentary. And then there is also the uploading and rendering, which... Oh yeah, by the way, you are now defending. Now defending. Carried for that team, I have to carry. I carry so hard for the defending team right here. I feel like every time I die, we are going to lose within the next few seconds. It doesn't happen while I'm dead, but it still feels like every time I die, it's over. This is it, but we'll see what happens. Yeah, rendering, uploading, rending. I always say rendering instead of rendering. Takes about an hour. Uploading takes about an hour. And there's a lot of babysitting involved, where even when you're not making videos, even when you're not putting time in to make said YouTube videos, that there still is a lot to monitor about a YouTube channel. It takes up a lot of time, trust me. And I'm not, once again, throwing this out here to complain or be like, hey, yo, you don't appreciate me. I have cooked dinner all day until you get home, and you just want to lay around. I don't care. I love doing this. I've set myself up for it. I do it all the time. It's because I want to do it. And it's really that simple. It can get kind of stressful because I like to put out videos frequently, and it always has that feeling, oh my god, I would really like to put something out right now. It's not really stressful because it's like, oh my god, I have to work on this. It's just more like, well, sometimes, yeah, oh my god, I have to work on this. But more so the stressful part comes from the fact that I don't really want to let people down. I know a lot of people enjoy watching these, so... I don't know. The times I'm not making videos, it's like, gosh darn me. People would wish I was doing this now or something. I don't even know. I'm probably going to make, and hopefully the near future, a video all about YouTubing in general, and if people are interested in getting into it, just various tips and other ramblings. So that would be a more appropriate time for this, but I have no idea when that's going to come out. I have gigantic lists of things that, like, hey, I would like to make this video, and this video, and this video, and there's just not enough time in the day. I mean, even a video daily is what I try and do. It is so hard to do that to begin with. So, that was a lot of rambling about nothingness right now. We're playing Demoman. That's what's going on. I am trying so hard to spam that sentry out and destroy it. My pills are just missing every single shot. I just could not get it. He finally got it up to a level 2, and maybe that helped me because it was finally a big enough target. You know, it's kind of his fault too that after how many pills I shot at him and missed, why did he never move that sentry? He just kept trying to build it and repair it. It was like, this is not going well for either of us. One of us needs to either succeed or quit while we're ahead. I saw that sniper try and shoot me. I figured he was done, though. I turned around to try and look for him. And I was like, oh, he got distracted. He's doing something else. But no, I get shot. People start attacking the cart. I think they actually do get it pushed kind of far right now. I don't really remember. This gameplay was rather long. No, this is not them pushing the cart, so there's still plenty of time for us to defend this. Last point on Barn Blitz is notoriously difficult to push, especially if people are not using the little overhang that's currently right behind me. If you're ever trying to push Barn Blitz, always use that. I don't care what class you are, I don't care what the situation is. Seriously, just use that. There is never, ever enough people coming up here. Like, right now it's just that one sniper. You can have, like, pyros rush in. They actually do use it a little bit more effectively later. If you get a demo man up here to just rain stickies down, and it is such a good spot, mixed with the typical people that will push from the front of Barn Blitz. Usually when you're playing on a pub, and you've got a whole bunch of random people, and you're just, you know, messing around having a match. Oh yeah, speeding through the chopper gunner gameplay once again. There is always majority of the people will push the obvious point. So they've got that covered. That flank is always covered of them just trying to attack that one main entrance. Know a little bit better, and when you know that an alternate route exists, like you're in Barn Blitz, go for that. Just do it. It'll probably work out way better than if you push with the bunch of people who are already doing that. One more random thing to throw in here that actually kind of does relate to what I was talking about before is that I was almost going to make like a poll to see what you guys, like what classes you like to see the most portrayed in Team Fortress. Like, maybe you do like Soldier the most, and it's just, I don't know. But I think the answer to that poll would kind of be like blindingly obvious that I think I pretty much already know the answer. That would either be, hey, you should play Spy because Spy is probably the most popular gameplay to watch. Spy. I don't like playing Spy that much. That's just unfortunate. I do make Spy gameplays every now and again, but I really, for the most part, don't like playing it all that often, and I rarely find the chance where I'm like, you know what, now would be a good time to be Spy. Usually, I don't know, just in general, seeing Spies, you feel useless to a certain extent. You know that. I always have the feeling when I kill people as a Spy, it's like, you know, if they were just, you know, paying a little bit more attention, I didn't deserve that. If I stair-stab someone, I'm just like, you know what, I didn't deserve that. You should have known that was coming. And that's probably the main reason I really don't feel like playing the class all that often. Unless there are a lot of sentries around and, like, level 3s to go after, then the class actually shines and does what it's supposed to do. Like, in the beginning of this video, there was a Spy sapping all of those sentries. That is great. It is so rare, I swear to you, so rare to see Spies that actually do stuff like that and do what they're best at. Backstabs. A lot of it's just trick stuff, and I don't really go for the, like, trick stabs or anything. My Spy is very basic, very methodical. I don't disguise as different people because I really don't think it makes a difference with my Spy playstyle. I just sort of, I use the cloak enough that people aren't really even seeing me in disguise mode all that often. But yeah, Spy would probably be the most requested. After that, I have a suspicion that Scout would probably be second, just because my Scout gameplays are a bit better than my other classes. The Scout is one of my best classes. But who knows? You can still let me know. I'm not going to go all out and like make an actual poll about it. I kind of do want to hear your opinion still. I'm interested to know what's really up beyond my own suspicions, but those are just my suspicions. Medic, they're actually using the Amputator. Also really nice to see a Medic use that effectively, where we had that many people around getting heals from it. And I see so few Medics use that weapon that I was actually really, really surprised how fast it healed me. Like, I was expecting that I was going to have to stand there as if it were, like, a level 1 dispenser healing me and it'd just, like, take forever. But no, that actually really, really worked extremely fast. So props to that Medic. This battle right here, what is going on? So yeah, props to the Medic, props to the Katana. I switched to that about halfway through the match because I had the thought that, you know, I want to use my grenade launcher, I want to use my sticky launcher, that's working well for me, but if there was only a melee weapon that could, you know, give me my health back, because I wasn't getting healed that much, but I had to keep running around looking for health back, so if only there was a melee weapon that could return health to you. And then I remembered that there was one, because there is, like, a weapon to return your health to you for every slot, for every class, pretty much. Everyone's got it. So, this is pretty much the end of the gameplay. I am going to have the opportunity to respawn one more time. The respawn times were so painful during this match. 17 seconds. I jump around the camera looking at spectator to see exactly how many people have the minimum field of view. Pretty funny. I also pretty funny that most of them were using back burners. I don't know, guys, if you haven't changed it already, please set your field of view to 90. It will help you out so much. It's some really simple configuration to change. You can tell it helps. It truly does help. I hope you guys enjoyed this. Like the video if you did, and peace out. Hope you didn't mind my rambling too much. Well, you did get to the end of the video. Yeah, bye.